This exquisite 16th century Elizabethan mansion was built back in 1590 by Sir Edward Culpeper. But today, these gardens are being celebrated for their pioneering 21st century achievements. So where am I, and how is this 400-year-old estate making such a name for itself? Find out in just a moment. Today's country property search has moments of light and shade.
I think it's fairly dark and it's a very bright day today. That would be a concern for me.
So can we leave our home hunters looking on the bright side?
Oh, just amazing.
Go and fetch my bags.
Today I'm in West Sussex and this is Wakehurst Place, surrounded by 465 acres of beautiful country estate, featuring an internationally renowned collection of trees, shrubs and plants, and managed by the Royal Botanic Gardens, Kew. But as well as a diverse range of mature species, in the year 2000 this site saw the opening of the Millennium Seed Bank, a conservation project aiming to conserve 25% of the entire world's plant species by 2020. It's certainly reassuring to think that here, in the West Sussex countryside, an integral part of our global heritage is being safeguarded for future generations. West Sussex is a county on the south coast of England, lying alongside the English Channel and bordered by three counties: Hampshire, Surrey and East Sussex. The county features the rolling hills of the South Downs National Park, a tapestry of quintessential English countryside, with glimpses of pretty spires, majestic castles and fields of sheep. The varied coast is home to towns such as the once wealthy Victorian resort of Bognor Regis and beaches ranging from sand to pebbles. There are also natural harbours, including the one at Chichester, whose sheltered waters are a popular stop for yachts. Market towns include Petworth, once voted Antiques Town of the Year, where the cobbled streets are pounded by regular collectors and day trippers alike, hoping to discover a hidden gem or two. So, whether it's to find glorious landscape, coastal vistas or charming towns and villages, it's clear West Sussex is an excellent choice for a rural relocation. As well as impressive countryside, West Sussex also has some impressive property stats. Easy access to the coast and to London has pushed the average detached house price up to around £433,000. Now that's over £140,000 above the national figure. But for something more affordable, try heading to the centre of the county. Towns such as Storrington offer a good property mix, while villages such as Fittleworth may lack in amenities, but more than make up for it with the surrounding countryside. So which part of this gorgeous county have today's buyers set their heart on? Well, let's meet them and find out. Chris, an accountant, and Jackie, who makes bespoke stationery, had been working together in London for a few years when an incident at an office party sparked a romance.
It was in the very late 90s, 99 actually. Christmas party came around. It was held in an old Victorian prison. So it's a bit like a Madame Tussauds type thing. I was kind of looking at some pretty horrific scene there, and Chris came over and an extremity fell off the wax thing, so it broke the ice, if you like.
Yeah, that was the icebreaker.
The couple went on to marry and set up home together in Clapham, a southwest district of the capital. But 15 years on, they're finding London life no longer meets their needs.
Originally, Clapham was not quite a backwater, but it was much quieter. Nowadays, there's a lot more development going on, a lot more people have moved to the area, especially a lot of young people, and so the profile of the area has changed quite a lot. The properties have got dearer, the bars have become more numerous, and the socialising in Clapham has really become a youngster sport.
So, with retirement on the horizon, they're looking to escape the hustle and bustle of the city for a calmer pace of life.
can get very noisy in this part of the world, especially in the location we are here. My lifestyle at the moment is basically going to bed Sunday nights, getting up Monday morning, going to work. I really only have a work-life balance over the weekend. Obviously, by moving to the country and eventually retiring, it will definitely change my lifestyle a lot.
The current house doesn't provide for me the peace and quiet that I would like. We live in a really built-up area. We just want to feel we have our own space around us. You know, I'm attracted to the countryside really because of the views, and you sort of associate the peace and tranquility with that.
They may agree that London is no longer for them, but when it comes to selecting a place to move to, there's some difference of opinion.
I would like to live nearer the coast. I have a requirement for being close to the sea.
I don't want to live in a seaside town. I'm erring on the countryside as being my ideal. We have been thinking of places to move, as say we have this dichotomy of wanting a little bit of coast, a little bit of country. So West Sussex has been one of the areas we've been considering.
Whether they settle by the sea or further inland, the hope is a new rural home in Sussex will offer them the chance to enjoy new pastimes.
The one thing I would really, really, really like to be able to do is to grow our own fruit and vegetables. I'm a really, really keen cook, and to be able to grow the produce and cook it, that's something I would dream of doing.
Moving to the country will also afford me the opportunity to develop my, you know, desire to do some more walking and also get on my bike and find some new different beers to drink.
Chris is a real fan of real ale, and you know that is actually, you should list it as one of your hobbies.
As well as access to a nice country pub, Chris is seeking something else from the move.
One thing I wouldn't like is my own effectively man cave. I don't seem to have one here at the moment. They're all occupied with other activities run by Jackie. Mm.
But most of all, it's about a new chapter together in new surroundings.
The new challenge, actually, that's what excites me most about the move. I'm really looking forward just to having new surroundings, new things to get involved in, the quieter way of life, doing the things that we can't do here, meeting new people, and, you know, see what that brings and opens up new horizons.
Jackie is drawn to the heart of the countryside, but Chris is keen to be close to the coast with an easy commute to London, meaning the net is cast wide on our West Sussex house hunt. But before we set about looking at houses, we're meeting up in the county to hear more about the property they're hoping to find.
Well, Chris and Jackie, welcome to the most gorgeous day here in West Sussex.
Hey. Amazing.
Let's talk about the actual property itself that you would like. Mm. Talk me through it.
Well, the property I think we'd like would be certainly detached, because we live in the terrace at the moment. We'd also look to have sort of the normal reception room, dining room, four bedrooms, garage, driveway and things like that.
What about the style? Do you like old? Do you like new? What's the preference?
I think we'd like older properties and something light and airy properties.
You know, so something with character. Yeah, exactly, character.
And Jackie, you've got your own business, I believe. Mm.
Yes, I have. I make handmade stationery. I suppose, really, you know, one of the things I have to have half an eye on when we look at any properties is space where I can operate out of a room, basically a craft room.
And then obviously to keep it fair, Chris, were you looking for a man cave at all, or...?
gym.
I'd like a room of my own. I don't have one at the moment.
You're not, OK.
No.
And location, are you looking to be part of a village community, or do you want to be near a market town, ideally? What works for the two of you?
Don't mind, personally, but we want to be near something.
I think there has to be some access to various things. Obviously, as you're getting older and we're thinking about retiring, you can't live in the middle of nowhere because you have to think longer term.
Remind us of how much you've got to spend with this move, please.
OK, we're looking to spend around £900,000. If the forever home, the ideal property came along, we probably go up to 1.1 million.
We do have some splendid homes to show you in this rather gorgeous part of the UK. So, shall we get started?
Oh, yes, please.
Ready? Yeah. Would you like to follow me?
For a maximum budget of £1.1 million, Chris and Jackie are looking for a detached property with a minimum of four bedrooms. Jackie needs space for her stationery business, and Chris would also like a room of his own. They prefer period character as long as it's bright and airy,
and the location needs to provide good transport links for Chris's commute back into London. We've got a selection of great homes to tempt our buyers with, and at each one I'll be asking them to guess the price before I reveal it. The final property will, of course, be our mystery house, which may cause something of a stir. Our house search is starting in the small village of Maidhurst, 2.5 miles northwest of the vibrant historic market town of Arundel. As well as a plethora of pretty and historic buildings, Arundel provides many useful shops, transport links and amenities. The town's impressive castle was built in the 11th century by Roger de Montgomery, Earl of Arundel, and heavily restored in Victorian times. It was one of the first English country houses to be fitted with electric lighting. And 2.5 miles away back in Maidhurst, the house we're going to see has a rather quirky history of its own. Now, if you can guess what this building was originally used for, I may even consider buying it for you.
It was part of an estate, and therefore it was the estate keeper's house.
Oh, thank goodness you didn't get it right, but you're close. You are close, because it is part of a larger estate. The huge manor house, which was next door, this was built as a squash court for the estate. Yes.
It's
amazing. Yeah.
Totally unexpected.
What do you think, Chris?
Well, my thought is, I'm intrigued to go inside to see how the light reflects through the windows, because there aren't that many windows at the front at the moment, and the porch does overhang a little bit.
No, that's a fair comment. Well, shall we step inside and see how it goes?
Oh, yes, super.
Thought to be built around the 1930s, but converted to a home in the 1980s, we're taking the door from the veranda at the back of the property and going straight into the kitchen breakfast room.
So let's start off with our country kitchen.
It's very stylish for me, if I was completely honest. It's all feeling a little bit low. It's done very nicely. It's, you know, bright, modern units. It just feels a little bit on the cramped side. I would be inclined to remove the island and open the whole thing up and make it one big sort of kitchen living space.
It would be huge then, wouldn't
it? Yeah, no, it'd be great in that format.
Let's see what you make of the next room.
Exiting the kitchen into the hall, the other side of the ground floor features the largest reception room.
So, off our hallway, this is your sitting room.
OK. It's actually a very spacious room.
It's a big room.
OK, dare I broach the subject of the windows and the light?
I think it's fairly dark and it's a very bright day today. That would be a concern for me.
Right, OK.
I agree with you. I mean, it's a little on the dark side.
OK.
You know, probably compared to what we're used to as well, but... And it is a bright day, so that is something, yeah. It's
all right. Well, let's head upstairs, see what you make of that.
OK.
So, some doubts expressed by Chris and Jackie over the ground floor, but there is additional space in a separate dining room next to the kitchen, as well as the convenience of a downstairs toilet. Perhaps the generous four-bedroom accommodation upstairs will be more to their liking. Over the sitting room, there's a large double with pretty views from two aspects. Another room currently has a day bed, but is large enough to take a double. And the smallest of the bedrooms, which is presently used as an office. These are all served by a family bathroom, and that just leaves the final room.
So here is the master bedroom, complete with ensuite.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. Now, this is a really much lighter room, brighter room.
So we're getting a slightly better reaction from upstairs,
though, yeah,
I think.
Yeah, it's a lovely room, and it's lighter, it's brighter, the ceiling is higher. Yeah, I like this room.
Yes, definitely.
And you've got your sunshine streaming through.
Yeah, yeah, and a beautiful view, actually.
You do.
Yeah.
You do. You're not overlooked, which you will see in more detail, because I'm going to take you outside.
A good finish for the interior, but there's more outside, where this property really shines. With lawns and terraces, plus beautifully stocked flower beds, the surprise feature in the garden is a large heated pool. Our buildings include a barn with storage and workshop that could give Chris a supersized man den. And there's also a double garage. What's more, light-loving Chris and Jackie should warm to the garden's aspect.
Southwest facing garden, So you're going to get the sunlight for most of the day, aren't you, into the evening?
No, it's a stunning space.
It's quite amazing compared to the house. I think the house wouldn't normally have a thing like this attached to it.
No.
Yeah.
No. It's certainly a bonus, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah, and adds more potential.
Let's see what it's on the market for. It'd be interesting to see what you two think.
925.
What about you, Jackie?
I'd say 875.
The asking price is £975,000.
Right. Mm-hmm. I'm pleasantly surprised. It's a lovely property.
Well, I think this is the opportunity for you two to take another look on your own this time, have a full explore. Must admit, with weather like this, I'm quite happy to wait for you in the garden, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Be my guest.
Significantly under their £1.1 million top budget, our first property meets many of the requirements on Chris and Jackie's wish list. It's detached with bags of individuality. There are four bedrooms, and there is the garage Chris asked for. In addition, there are good-sized grounds with entertaining spaces, as well as that large heated pool. Plus, it's a 90-minute commute to London from nearby Arundel Station.
I think it's an amazing property. The amount of land surrounding it and the gardens are just beautiful. I think the house itself may be a little bit small for our requirements.
Probably I'd give it a 50-50, because the house may be so-so, but the garden very much so.
Oh, you've caught me enjoying the rays of sunshine, and I do love this garden. It's gorgeous, isn't it?
It's an amazing garden, yes.
It is. So, have you seen enough of the house?
Yes, I think we have.
Yeah?
Yeah.
OK, well, that's the end of this house tour. Let's hit the road.
Winemaking was first introduced to England by the Romans, and as one of the sunniest spots in the country, with a similar subsoil to the Champagne region of France, West Sussex is a wonderful location for vineyards. In fact, there are no fewer than 31 in the county, producing a selection of world-class wines. We've arranged for Chris and Jackie to visit one of the county's oldest vineyards on the very first day of this year's harvest. They're meeting Sam Linter, whose parents established the Bolney Wine Estate in 1972.
So your parents founded this estate. What made them choose this area?
Bolney has a really good microclimate. It actually has sandstone soils, and that soil is really good for vines. It keeps the vineyard warmer, which is vital, but also it's free draining, as vines don't like getting wet roots.
Warmer weather at the end of the summer has meant bumper crops in recent years, and this is looking to be another excellent season for grape growing. It takes 75 to 100 berries to make a single glass of wine. And with 128 million to collect over the next 3 weeks, Chris and Jackie are joining Amy Knight from the estate to get the harvest started.
So what makes a good bunch of grapes?
So what we look for is even fruit. So we want the berries to all be of a similar sort of size, and we also want them to be of a similar colour. So we don't want any green berries in our nice black bunch here.
Several varieties of grape are grown here, but the one our couple are helping to harvest is called Rondo, a dark-skinned hybrid developed to mature early, as well as cope with a slightly cooler and wetter climate.
So, Amy, what do these grapes taste like?
Have a taste, see what you think.
Right, they're actually quite sweet.
Well, shall we head down to the tasting room so you can try the final product?
Sounds good to me.
The yield from the estate's 42,000 vines will be pressed to produce a juice, and sugar and yeast added to start the fermentation process. It will take up to 4 years before this season's harvest turns into wines that are ready to drink. Fortunately for Chris and Jackie, Amy has some they made earlier.
So have you ever tried any English wines?
No, never.
Oh, OK. Well, let's start with our 2009 Blanc de Blanc. So this is 100% Chardonnay, this wine. It's made in the traditional method, so the same way as champagne. It spends a minimum of 2.5 years aging, which gives it sort of some yeasty, honeyed, autolytic sort of flavours. But because Chardonnay is quite an acidic grape, you should also get quite a lot of lemon, some green apple, quite a clean, refreshing mouthfeel with this one. So, cheers.
Cheers.
So, what do you think?
That is lovely. Light, very crisp.
I said I could drink this one.
Yeah. So moving on to our white wine, the grape variety is Bacchus. It's of Germanic origin. It's very floral, very fruity. It's ever so slightly sweeter as well.
Well, the fruit really comes through in that.
Yeah, very fruity, very pleasant.
Yeah.
And finally, our red wine. So this is our Bolny Pinot Noir. And it's a cool climate red wine, so it's very, very light. You'll be able to see from the colour, you can see through the wine. You get a lot of kind of sweet red berries on the nose, and on the palate you should get only a low amount of tannin in this wine.
Mm. Wow, very surprising. That would be lovely chilled in the summer, a very good summer wine, I think.
Yes, I get the berries, it's very light as well, very sort of reminiscent of some of the reds I like.
Yeah, great summer wine, as you were saying.
So what do you think about English wine?
But it's certainly opened my eyes, I can tell you. The wines we've tasted here are fantastic.
Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Well, let's hope Chris and Jackie soon have a new country address to toast to when their house hunt continues tomorrow. It's day two of our property search with Chris and Jackie from Clapham, South London, who have a top budget of £1.1 million to buy their dream forever home in West Sussex. So far, we've shown them some great property, but there's more to see, and our mystery house could be just what they're looking for.
Literally walked through a door and went, wow, and I'm still saying wow, so it's all good.
Yes.
And I'm visiting somewhere in West Sussex that really rings a bell.
I'm a good trainee campanologist, but...
I would love to have you as a trainee, Nikki.
Well, it's a new day, and of course, it's the Mystery House Day. This time, we're going to be taking a couple further away down to the coast, something we know Chris adores. However, it will mean a longer commute back to the capital. But first, a property that's closer to the city, but still has all the wonderful countryside views. Let's see what they make of it.
Our house hunt is taking us further inland and across the county border to the Surrey village of Wolliswood, 3.5 miles west of the village of Ockley. Ockley station provides a regular train service to London, Victoria, with travel times of around 1.25 hours. There's also a pretty farm shop here. 3.5 miles west, back in Wolliswood, the pump on the village green has a tiled roof, stone pillars, and carved wooden gables that typify the local style. The 17th century village pub takes its name from the Scarlett family, who once owned much of the land here. And it's a 10-minute walk from the house we've come to see.
What do we think of the house?
It actually looks really interesting. It's lovely.
It looks very large as well.
Yes.
A promising start, do we feel?
Yes.
Quite optimistic.
Yeah. Wood-boarded, very attractive, on a very quiet road. Let's see what you make of the inside.
Thought to be built around the 1850s, this detached Victorian country home retains many period features, including the high ceilings Chris and Jackie love. We're entering via a back door in the sympathetically done extension, which houses the big and bright kitchen breakfast room.
I do love it when you start a house tour with a really generous-sized kitchen.
Really lovely.
It's very nice, very large.
And then you have those wonderful patio doors looking out onto your garden.
Yeah, it's a lovely aspect, really is.
I appreciate it will be very light.
So this is my idea of a kitchen dining space.
Is it?
Yeah, especially looking out over the garden like that. Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah. You can see both of you in here of the weekend.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, yeah.
You'll be out there digging up the vegetables and I'll be in here cooking them.
Already got the rolls sorted out. OK, let's keep going.
Off the kitchen, we also find a utility, downstairs cloakroom, and snug. Then, heading out through the main entrance hall, we arrive at the sitting room.
We actually passed the front door. We never use that, do we?
It's a nice shape room. You know, it's quite good having a square room when it comes to laying out furniture and TVs and whatnot. And it's a higher ceilings, which is good. It is a nice room.
Chris, big fan of the fire?
If someone makes it, yes.
Would you like to see a little bit more?
Oh, certainly would, yeah.
Great, I'll squeeze past you, thank you.
They both seem to be warming to the character and proportions of this home so far. And opposite the sitting room, a similarly square-shaped, elegant dining room boasts another feature fireplace. The classic staircase leads up to four bedrooms, all fanning off the landing. There's a good-sized guest double above the dining room and two smaller rooms, each currently arranged with single beds. The compact family bathroom has both a shower and bath. And then, to the rear of this floor, there's the generously sized master ensuite.
Another lovely room. Amazing ceiling.
Yeah, now you do have the height.
We won't be ducking these beams.
Behind me, good-sized wardrobe.
Wow, yeah.
And then behind that, just as we walk through, a really good ensuite bathroom with a bath.
Mm. It's lovely. The windows actually give the room character as well.
Great. All right, well, let's see what we think of outside.
What a wonderful reception for the interior of this charming home. Outside, in the half acre of grounds, there's a ready-made vegetable patch right outside the kitchen, as well as a pleasant terrace with seating. There's also a barn-style garage and tranquil country views.
How green-fingered do you want to be when you make this move?
Something I'm interested in doing is because I want to grow herbs and vegetables, so the area closer to the house would be perfect for that, you know. And your man cave could be up the end here somewhere under an oak tree.
Well, let's see, shall we, if the price is pleasant.
Well, I think it's probably top end of our budget. I would say around the 1.1 mark.
OK.
And to be different, I'll say 1075.
OK, well, you're both out by quite a lot. The asking price is under £1 million.
Wow.
It's £995,000.
OK.
That's surprising.
Very surprising.
Well, I'm glad. Yeah. That's a positive reaction with our price. So now you know. I think you should go and have another look around.
Yeah, I think love so too. To.
Yeah? Right. Good. Go on then. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well under budget, this Victorian country residence has all the accommodation Chris and Jackie require. It comes with a large kitchen breakfast room, four bedrooms, including that generous master ensuite, a well-stocked garden with beautiful countryside on the doorstep, and all with the added convenience of London transport links nearby.
I'm actually very surprised at how big the house is, and I think it could offer us the type of accommodation we've been looking for. Locationally, it looks to be well situated for us, you know, to have this lifestyle that we're looking for. It offers us the period features that we've wanted and the character that we really wanted as well.
It ticks a lot of the boxes in terms of the features, the space, the size.
It's a great house and I can see us living in it.
How are we?
Impressed.
Yeah, a very positive house tour, this time in Surrey.
Yeah.
Seen enough?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah.
OK, let's go.
As well as the beauty of its countryside, West Sussex is rich in history and architectural heritage. Located at the southwestern tip of the county, the cathedral city of Chichester was once a Roman settlement. And there is still evidence of the Roman influence to this day, with the city wall standing as the most intact circuit of Roman town defences in southern England. Elsewhere, one of the most striking sights is the cathedral, which has stood at the heart of Chichester for 900 years. Subsequent generations have also left their mark here, for it's possible to admire both exterior medieval architecture and interior 20th century artworks. Today, I'm finding out about the history and continuing work in this impressive ecclesiastical building, starting with a welcome from the Dean of the Cathedral, Stephen Wayne.
This is my first time here at Chichester Cathedral, and it really is magnificent.
It is a jewel in the crown of Chichester. It's beautiful. It was begun in the year 1076, and although it was finished relatively quickly, there were a couple of disastrous fires, which means that it was dedicated for the second time in the year 1199. Since then, it's been added to and beautified and restored at various times throughout the history. It's scarcely a century in which something important hasn't happened here in terms of the building.
Out of the whole of the West Sussex countryside, why did they decide that Chichester should be its home?
Originally, there was a cathedral in Selsey, but at that particular period, they were bringing bishops in from the countryside into centres of population, and the old Roman town of Chichester was one of the major centres of population.
Now, standing here, you know, you can see the building in all its glory. Mm. I mean, what's it like trying to maintain a historic building like this?
It's a constant task with a building of this age. If you don't attend to the small things, very, very quickly they become large things. Just at the moment, we're behind us here, we've got some scaffolding, we're fixing a historic roof up there.
Is that ongoing? Is that something I could perhaps take a look at?
It is ongoing. Why don't you go and have a look? You'll find it absolutely fascinating when you get up there.
I'm looking forward to this.
Good.
This is certainly one building site I'm keen to look around. An acting clerk of works, Tony Allen, has offered to show me the latest projects and the incredible view.
What can we see?
Well, over there you've got the Isle of Wight, Portsmouth, in the far distance, Southampton.
A height of 274 feet to the top of the spire may offer panoramic views, but the exposed coastal location takes its toll on the fabric of the building.
I mean, we can feel the wind today. Mm.
And where we're stood, we suffer predominantly from southwest winds. So it comes across here, across the Solent, and it batters all the stone, if you wish. So it's eroding the stone as you look at it.
Is this what this is, all these ridges?
Correct.
And this will all have to be repaired in time?
In time, each piece will have to be replaced.
This is also the only medieval cathedral with a separate bell tower, or campanile. It's a 15th century structure that is sadly showing its age.
That is a very bad state of repair. We're going to be looking at refurbishing that in the next couple of years, so we'll be trying to raise funds for that. We're talking in the region of £4 million, just to restore the stonework externally.
Meanwhile, the bell tower is very much a living building. The bell ringers, also known as campanologists, have the task of peeling out a ring from up to 8 bells in the lantern. Regular ringer Hamish has agreed to give me some instruction at a practice session.
Hello, Hamish.
Hello, Nikki. Welcome to Chichester.
Thank you. Now, I'm looking forward to this, because this is a first. I've never rung a bell before. I want you to look after me, because I'm not going to end up in the rafters, am
you
I?
You certainly won't.
OK.
I'll make sure of that.
Thank you. Right.
And the rope will take your hands up. Keep the rope tight. OK. I'm going to put my hand on top of yours the first few times.
Okay.
To make sure your hands do come down.
Okay.
Here we go.
I'm concentrating now. Oh! That sounds amazing.
Try and pull straight down. Perfect. That was a really good pull down.
I'm a good trainee campanologist, but...
I would love to have you as a trainee, Nikki.
Yeah?
Okay.
Hand over the rope.
Okay.
Take it away. Thank you.
Okay.
Well, time for me to leave bell number 4 in the capable hands of the regular ringers, as they peel out a ring that has been sounded out for more than half a millennium. Our mystery proposition sees us leave behind the depths of rural life to tempt Chris to the coast, but at the cost of a longer commute. We're 5 miles west of Brighton in the small seaside town of Southwick. Here there are pretty harbours and marinas with views across the English Channel. The town has plenty of easy-to-reach amenities, including pubs and a train station, giving Chris those all-important links to London.
Now, I think you might have guessed why we picked this property.
I think because it might be on the coast.
It's on the coast. It's on the coast. It's also on a road that, you know, we have to be aware of, with a little bit more traffic than you might be used to in the country. But, yeah, we are about 15 minutes from the marina here in Southwick. So on first impressions, what do we think?
An impressive house.
It's a very big, large house.
Large house.
Well, shall we step inside, see what you make of it?
Yes, please.
Despite not being in the heart of the countryside, the exterior appeal of our mystery house seems to be of interest to Chris and Jackie. Built in the 1900s, the Edwardian home was recently extended by the current owners to create a very grand space with a large entrance hall leading into an elegant dining room.
This isn't a small house.
Certainly not.
So here's your hallway, larger than some people's homes. In here, I like the way it's open. Dining room. But then, what do we make of this?
Just amazing.
Go and fetch my bags. This is fantastic, seriously.
Amazing.
It's out of a Homes magazine, you know, one of those glossy magazines. It's fantastic.
Let's take a look at the sitting room next door.
A well-designed utility lies off the kitchen, whilst back through the hall, the first of two sitting rooms again boasts those Edwardian high ceilings.
And this is just another big room.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely a very comfortable sitting room, and the window lets in loads of light. It's so huge.
That's an original fireplace.
Yeah.
Certainly feels like I could live here.
Yeah. And so far it has the wow factor. Literally walked through a door and went, wow. And I'm still saying wow, so it's all good.
Yes, you can keep saying it, I'll be very happy. Well, I take it you'd like to see upstairs then?
Yes, please.
OK, thank you.
This impeccably presented Edwardian home has certainly enchanted our couple. The ground floor also offers the first of three bathrooms, plus there's the second sitting room. But there's still a lot more to see. A wide staircase takes us to the first of two upper floors with a total of five bedrooms, a good-sized double to the front of the house, next to which is a slightly smaller bedroom, and another spacious double to the side. There's also a family bathroom with separate WC, typical of this period of home. And finally, at the back of the house is a very large bedroom with ensuite.
Try your master bedroom out for size.
Oh, crikey.
It's not a very, very large room.
The most beautiful ensuite walk-in shower in their bathroom. Absolutely gorgeous.
This would certainly work for us, wouldn't it? This
certainly
room.
It's a master bedroom, certainly.
Yeah.
It's a lot of walk-around space.
We're on course, aren't we?
Yeah.
But we haven't got the man den. But how would you feel about having a man attic?
I could cope with that, yes.
Yeah. You nearly broke into a smile there, Chris.
It's very
broke
unusual.
Into sweat.
Because above us, they've actually got into the loft. And it's huge up there.
Certainly food for thought.
Yeah.
The house has far more positives than negatives, so, yeah.
Super.
Well, let's see if our mystery house can build on those positives outside, where the enclosed gardens have been professionally landscaped, whilst retaining many mature shrubs and trees. There are a couple of greenhouses and a shed, as well as large areas of well-maintained lawn.
So here we have our beautiful long garden.
Very neat, very tidy.
Yeah, and it's a mature garden, lots of interesting things to look at. Yeah.
You're looking at an hour 40 to Victoria from here, and then obviously you've got to get to the train station, which isn't too far. It is walking distance, but still a little bit more on your journey every day. And I know you work pretty long hours.
Yes. It's certainly a very big consideration in any decision to buy something like this.
So what do we think? How much do you think it's on the market for?
£950.
Okay.
I think maybe £995.
The asking price is, bang on, £1 million.
If it was a house for us, I would be happy to pay that.
Oh, that was quite telling. That's the big question mark, isn't it? Well, go and have another look around, and I'll find you in a little while. Thank you.
Thank you.
It is such a beautiful home. Exquisite garden, but I think the penny is dropping with Chris. I think even if I found him the most amazing house right near the coast with a very quick commute to London, I still think it would be too far for him. It makes it such a long working day, and that's, I think, in their heads, what they've got to work out, where the priority is.
This impressive Edwardian property has wowed Chris and Jackie and leaves them £100,000 in their budget. There's a stunning kitchen diner, 3 additional reception rooms, 5 bedrooms, including that attic room that could make a man cave, and the coastal location is close to amenities, including rail links to London.
The mystery house is stunning. The high ceilings and all the period features are exactly what I want to see in my next house. It's just the wow factor, really has the wow factor.
I think the mystery house is actually great. There's the footprint, the size, the space. What I really like is the light, airy, spacious feel you get from walking from room to room. I think the commute of an hour and 40 on the train, if you're doing 10 plus hour days, it becomes untenable for a long period of time.
So that's it. You've seen all our properties. You two need to have a little bit of a chat, and then we'll find out what your next move's going to be. Well, we've certainly ended on a high note here in West Sussex with our mystery house, but the question is, how high? Let's go and ask them. Well, Chris and Jackie, we are desperate to get you away from the big smoke for a new life in the country. Have we got close, I wonder?
I think you've got close to a property that we really do like.
Well, 2 properties we really do like. Yeah, it's the location, I think, is the sort of sticking point.
Well, let's talk about the actual properties themselves. Put me out of my misery, then. Which were the 2 that you loved?
We like the house in Southwick. We also like the house in...
Wolliswood.
Yes.
Yeah, in Wolliswood. I think they're very different houses themselves, but each had so much to offer and ticked an awful lot of boxes.
I think it's the commute aspect of life is the one that's really coming to the forefront of my mind at the moment. And obviously that's very key while I'm still working in the city.
It's really helped us now to... We can see what we like and what we don't like.
Well, I'm glad we've been able to help.
No, I definitely think we're much closer, you know, than we were a few days ago even. You know, I feel very positive.
Well, it's been great. We've loved showing you around, so all the very best. And, well, I hope you get to move very soon. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Well, we may not have finalised our house sale with Chris and Jackie, but what we did do was find them the perfect home, just frustratingly in the wrong location. But I think the last few days has really helped them fine-tune what it is they want from this new country lifestyle that they so crave. They've just got to decide on the exact location and the rest will fall into place. We wish them all the very best wherever they end up. And I'll see you again on Escape to the Country.
If you would like to escape to the country in Northern Ireland, Scotland, Wales or England and need our help, please apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.